Hi and assalamualaikum to my fellow lecturers. My name is Nur Nabila Mutad Rahman. Today I'm presenting my final year project progress under the title of Development of Water Quality Index Model for Kuantan River Basin Pahang by using multiple linear regression. I am under supervision of Dr. Azman bin Aziz. Alright, so the content for my presentation falls into four main elements: the introductions, material and methods, progress to date, and finally pass forward. So firstly, the introduction, okay, the background of study. Basically, Kuantan River Basin is a major source of water supply for domestic, agriculture and industry purposes that provides about 350,000 cubic meters per day. Kuantan area are being rapidly developed in last decades and leading to the environmental degradation. According to the Department of Environment, 2016, the Kuantan River has been classified as Class 2 in both year of 2015 and 2016 with water quality index of 86 and 77. Therefore, advanced mathematical tools such as MLR can be used as a medium to protect the sustainability of the river water quality in the development of water quality index prediction model. Next, problem statements. Firstly, the rapid urbanization followed by anthropogenic activities including tourism and recreations along the Kuantan River has been negatively impacting the river water quality as the major source of water supply, as the Kuantan River has been said to provide about 350,000 cubic meters per day. And next is the confusion in large number of variables, in which variables contribute the most in variable of water quality index. Thus, the reduction in the number of parameters are needed by eliminating the independent variable of parameters in carry out the water quality prediction without much loss of information. The significance of my study. Firstly, the development of this water quality index model for Kuantan River will contribute in easier prediction of water quality of Kuantan River in the future with significant input data by researchers and the government agencies. And next, this prediction model can also help in protecting the sustainability of river water quality, as the model with significant dependent variables make the sampling process become more efficient and can be done continuously for closed river water monitoring. And lastly, the water quality index model has not been established yet in Kuantan River. Thus, this will fill the research gap in academic world. The main two objectives from my study is to first identify essential monitoring station and water quality variable with acceptable accuracy. Second is to develop the water quality index prediction model for Kuantan River Pahang. Methods. There are 9 main steps identified in my study, which I'll start with study area description. Next, data collection which monitored by Kuliah of Science IIUM Kuantan. Third is monitoring site identification. Fourth is filtering data process. Fifth is descriptive statistics. Sixth is principal component analysis. Seventh is cluster analysis, and followed by water quality index calculation. And lastly, multiple linear regression application. Okay, first, the study area description. Okay, as you can see here, the yellow X mark is where my study area located at Pahang State, which located in the east coast of Peninsula Malaysia. Pahang has tropical monsoon climate, which is warm and humid throughout the years, with temperature ranging from 21 degrees Celsius to 33 degrees Celsius, and rainfall average about 200 millimeters monthly. My study area, the Kuantan River, is specifically located in Kuantan region of Pahang. The red colour is the Kuantan River with 80x km of length. Kuantan River flows from Sungai Lembing through Kuantan City before flowing out to the South China Sea. Actually, Kuantan River flows through mixed uses of lands. Kuantan River is known to be a major source of water supply, which, as I stated before, provided about 350 cubic meter per day for domestic, agriculture and industry purposes. Next is secondary data collection. In this study, the secondary data are used, obtained from Kuliah of Science IIUM Kuantan. This includes of 12 monitoring sites. It is 1D data, which observed on 30th of April 2014, with about 30 parameters are observed. So, monitoring site identification is done based on the coordinates given by the Kuliah of Science IIUM Kuantan. So, here I map those sampling sites with references to the Google Map. Fourth is filtering data process, which this is done by calculating the average of all data, as data was observed triplicate for accuracy. And then the data was extracted, which water quality data with suitable units was taken, while the heavy metal data was discarded. Fifth is descriptive statistics, which by using SLSTAT software, in order to measure central tendencies such as range, median, third quarter and mean, and also variability such as minimum, maximum variance and standard deviation. 6, the principal components analysis is done through SLSTAT software. The average data was analyzed by PCA. And then the result of eigenvalue was observed, which the value of 1 or greater was accepted. And lastly, the variable rotation was carried out. The principal component analysis is important as to identify variation in the data, to determine the principal components of the data through the eigenvalue, and lastly, function as to identify the most significant data and essential monitoring stations. 7 is cluster analysis. This analysis was done through the LSTAT software using agglomerative hierarchical clustering, AHC, in order to classify the data into relative cluster and also to determine the accuracy of the cluster obtained from the PCA. Next is water quality calculation. This is to obtain the water quality index. The individual quality index will be summed up and the parameters will be weighed using a total quality evaluation. The final water quality index is obtained using this formula. The application of multiple linear regression using LSTAT software. The MLR generally applied in every environment problem in order to justify the relationship between the water quality parameters and their impact on the water quality index. An MLR model takes the form such as I paste here, and the adjusted R-square value will be calculated using the same formula below. This value will indicate the loss of predictive power and shows how much variance in the Y would be accounted for if the model is derived from the population for which the sample was taken. And MLR was used in development of water quality index prediction model. The progress to date. Firstly, the result of the eigenvalues of the principal component analysis. An eigenvalue illustrates the most significant factors, and the eigenvalues of 1 or greater are considered significant. The two eigenvalues greater than 1 shown above, explaining that there are 93% of the total communities in the water quality data set. And next, the factor loadings after variable rotation, PCA, was performed on the raw data set comprising the 12 water quality parameters in order to identify the variable that contribute to the pollution sources in the Kuantan River Basin. Here resulted in the two variable factors were adjusted after variable rotation based on the eigenvalue greater than 1. The variable factors 1 with eigenvalue of 10.065 represent 83.87% of the total variability in one which has high values of temperatures, total dissolved solid, total suspended solid, turbidity, biological oxygen demand, chemical oxygen demand, ammonium nitrate, and negatively load of dissolved oxygen. This can be interpreted as due to the anthropogenic input, typically organic or inorganic pollution, being discharged into the river such as sewage treatment plant, poultry farms, agriculture runoff, and surface runoff from the urban area. While variable factors of 2 with 9.406% of variance shows the high value of pH, salinity, and electrical conductivity. This is due to the both Tanjung Ali and Tanjung Lumpur is the brackish water. That salinity is high and along with the pH and also the electrical conductivity. Next is the summary of regression of variable water quality index. Results show that the use of PCA as inputs improved the MLR model prediction as by reducing the complexity and eliminating data collinearity. R-square value in this study is 0.991 and the model indicates 99% variability of water quality index explained by the two variables used in the model. The two variables involved based on the model of water quality index equation are dissolved oxygen and chemical oxygen demand. These two variables were important as chemical oxygen demand is the total amount of oxygen required to oxidize chemical substances present in the water. And those variable factors 1 and 2 indicates that the source of apportionment might become from the urban domestic and involve chemical substances being discharged into rivers such as from agriculture pesticide, hospital wastewater and detergents. And dissolved oxygen is also important parameter as the level of oxygen will depleted as the chemical oxygen demand is increased as both are correlated with each other. Okay, this is my pass forward, which illustrates that my study just left with poster presentation, thesis writing, and thesis submission. So basically, the study is started at October 2020 and expected until June 2021. So in conclusion, and to brief the presentation that this study is developing water quality index model for Kuantan River Basin may benefit the river itself in terms of sustainability and also Department of Environmental and other agency in efficient environmental monitoring in Malaysia. So this is for my presentation, and thank you.